Hello everyone, you are all welcome to lecture number 726, and today's topic is the structural determination of alpha terpenoyl, and that alpha terpenoyl contains 10 carbon, hydrogen 18 and 1 oxygen. This alpha terpenoyl is a natural product and it is isolated mostly from plant source like gold mary flower and then orange peel oil. So in this way all these flowers and some of the orange lemon peels, they contain alpha terpenoyl. It is monocyclic, monoterpene, and it is unsaturation is there. It contains double bond, and this alpha terpenoyl is very important from biological point of view. First, it is a very good antioxidant, and secondly, it is a very good insecticide, and also it is used in lot of pharmaceutical industries for different type of preparations. This alpha terpenoyl is having three more isomeric form. One it is alpha terpenoyl, other one is beta terpenoyl, third one is gamma terpenoyl, and fourth one is 4 terpenoyl. And these isomeric forms they depend upon the different positions of double bond and alcoholic group. So when we are saying to determine the structure of this alpha terpenoyl, means we have to see in detail the number of carbon that is it is having, C10, H18 and 1 oxygen. So how these 10 number of carbons they are arranged, what is the carbon skeleton, whether it is cyclic form, open chain, aliphatic, aromatic, then 18 hydrogen means it is short in hydrogen, because if you apply saturated hydrocarbon formula CN H2N plus 2, means there should have been 20 hydrogen, so it is 18, it means it is short in hydrogen, so it shows that it must contain saturated. Unsaturated condition means it must have double bond. Then what is the position of oxygen? Whether this oxygen is in the form of aldehyde, in the form of alcohol, or in the form of ketone. And all this we have to discuss on the basis of oxidative, that is your reaction, oxidative degradation. On the basis of oxidation and on the basis of bromination, on the basis of esterification, to understand the structure. So I will be discussing one by one. So first is that once the question is asked, because this lecture is mainly for advanced course, those who are doing mainly in terpene chemistry, and that's why we need the structure determination. Because if you go to some library or Google, all those places, they are not determining the structure. They will just discuss the medicinal importance, pharmaceutical importance, or biological importance. That, for that, I have already given a lot of information about terpenes, their biological importance. But here I will be discussing some few terpenes, how to determine their structures. So first is that once we are doing the reaction, in the reaction, we can get acetate, we can get phthalate. So once it gives these two derivatives, it clearly shows that it contains alcoholic group. And only alcoholic group can give the derivatives of phthalate and acetate. And once we are doing dehydration, very easily it undergoes dehydration, means hydroxy group is easily removed from the alpha terpenoyl, and this dehydration very easily means this alcoholic group is tertiary, because once the alcoholic group is primary or secondary, the dehydration will not be easy. So easily dehydration is taking place, means removal of alcoholic group, means that alcoholic group is not very stable, and it is not very stable only when it is tertiary. So two things are confirmed with these two reactions. One, that it contains alcoholic group because it gives phthalate and acetate. Second, it undergoes dehydration very easily, and that confirms that it is tertiary, the alcoholic group. Now, when alpha tryptophan is subjected to bromination, it gives dibromide derivative, and again, if it is subjected to hydrogenation, it gives dihydro derivative of alpha tryptophan. So these two derivatives, dibromo and dihydro derivative, means it is consuming one molecule of bromine or one molecule of hydrogen. It confirms that it contains one double bond, and still it is not following that open chain formula, that is CnH2n plus 2, but CnH2n formula is followed with this 20 after consuming one molecule of bromine. It confirmed that it is monocyclic. So here, the structure determination of alpha tryptophan, which has molecular formula C10H18O, and here I am going to discuss how to determine the structure on the basis of chemical reactions. So first I am giving the introduction. Alpha tryptophan is a terpene alcohol that is found in natural essential oil like pine oil from the bitter orange tree. It is found in most common structural isomers like alpha, beta, gamma and 4 tryptophan structure I have given here. Alpha tryptophan is a desirable ingredient for perfume and cosmetics. It is monocyclic, monoterpene, and it is unsaturated alcohol, and can be found in flowers like rosemary. In Indian language we call it gende ka phool. It is alpha tryptophan is rich in that, and in orange peel oil. Orange peel from upper side, if you take peel it, and that one if you extract the oil, that is rich in alpha tryptophan. It has wide range of biological applications, like it is a very good antioxidant and anti-cancer, anti-ulcer, and it has insecticidal property. So in this way, it is a very good antioxidant and anti-ulcer as well as anti-cancerous property. And nowadays it is used for a lot of preparation in pharmaceutical industries as well as in perfume industries. So these four isomeric forms are given. And these four isomeric forms, they are different only in double bond and alcoholic group. The first one is, that is called alpha tryptophan, which has this structure, and where hydroxy group is shifted to this methyl position, and then it is called, and double bond is here, beta tryptophan. And when double bond is shifted to here, 8 and 9 carbon position, then it is called gamma tryptophan. And when the hydroxy group is at 4th position, that is called 4 tryptophan. Alpha tryptophan means it has molecular formula C10H18O. Whenever question is asked, determine the structure of alpha tryptophan, how will you prove the presence of alcoholic group, the presence of double bond, and how will you prove that it is cyclic, it is not open chain? So all these are real chemistry. Once you don't know how to determine the structures of all these terpenes, alkaloid, flavonoid, it means your chemistry is incomplete. So once the formula is given, that is C10H18O, it means you have to discuss each and every element in this, carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, and you have to prove it, that whether they are alcoholic, whether they have unsaturation, whether the carbon skeleton is cyclic, parasimony structure or not. So one by one, on the basis of reaction, we will be discussing. So once the question comes to discuss the structure of alpha terpenol, first is that its molecular formula is C10H18O. Second, when it is subjected to reaction, means it is treated with phthalic acid or with some other to form the acetate, esterification, means it is alcohol, and once it is treated with organic acid, it will form ester. So once it is forming ester and it is forming phthalate, this confirms that it is containing alcoholic group. So here it has molecular formula C10H18O. Second point, the oxygen atom present. I am talking of this oxygen atom. The oxygen atom present in an alcoholic group. So here the oxygen is found in the form of alcoholic group. And how you will prove that it is in the form of alcoholic group? Because it gives two reactions. It forms acetate, it forms phthalate, and both are stable. And both can be isolated in pure form. We can crystallize them. Or either by fractional distillation or by crystallization, we can get in pure form, and it confirms that it is having alcoholic group. So the oxygen atom present in an alcoholic group, and the presence of alcoholic group is confirmed by the formation of derivatives like acetate and phthalate, and these derivatives can be obtained in pure form either by crystallization or by fractional distillation. So now here I have given the introduction of alpha terpenol, and we have reached to that structure determination about oxygen, one point. And one point is that since it is forming derivatives like acetate and phthalate, it confirms that it contains alcoholic group. Now this third point I will be discussing in the next lecture, that this alcoholic group, whether it is primary alcoholic group, secondary alcoholic group or tertiary alcoholic group, on the basis of reaction and its stability. If it is unstable, it means it is tertiary. And if this alcoholic group is stable, means it is primary. So that can be proved on the basis of reaction. So I will continue in the next lecture, because there are a lot of reactions to be discussed to establish the structure, where we will discuss all the carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and how they are in the form of alpha terpenol structure. Thank you very much for watching the lecture.